This is what a North Korean missile test looks like from space. The image taken not by a billion-dollar government spy satellite, but by one of these, the size of a loaf of bread, launched by a Silicon Valley company that is changing how we see Earth. Planet Labs operates the largest and least expensive fleet of satellites in history, the first to take pictures of the entire landmass of the globe once a day and sell them to the public.
Last year, we built roughly as many satellites as the whole world put together.
Will Marshall, a former NASA spacecraft designer, built Planet's first satellite in a garage. Now, his company is valued at $2 billion.
Your images have chronicled the growth of refugee camps in Syria and elsewhere.
Yeah, there's a huge number. We were recently involved in a situation where some refugees got trapped, if you like, in a conflict zone, and our imagery proved that there were civilians on the ground and they needed evacuating from that conflict area. But the data has a wide variety of humanitarian uses. So earthquakes, fires, floods, typhoons, tsunamis, we can help because we have an image the day before, the image afterwards, help responders quickly get in there. And we've done that numerous times. Like last year, we were helping with the Indonesian earthquake, assessing the damage, helping the response efforts. And there's lots of other humanitarian ones too. So tracking and stopping deforestation. We work with a Brazilian NGO that actually our data was used in the court of law to prove that landowners had allowed deforestation on their territory, and then they got held accountable for it. And that's the beginning of really stopping it permanently. Not just knowing that it exists, but that we stop it.
When this Iowa town flooded in March, state officials didn't know how bad it was until they saw these images. The bird's eye view helped them better coordinate their response. The company has stuffed a lot of technology into a small package.
They call this a dove, and it weighs about as much as a bowling ball. But it's packed with a powerful telescope and a sophisticated camera.
Planet's fleet of 140 satellites beams back 1.2 million images a day, telling visual stories over time, like how this city sprang up on a man-made island near Singapore. In a small test, we laid out a blue tarp on the roof of our Washington bureau one day and took it away the next. Planet satellites capture the change, just as they record millions of other developments on the Earth's surface, big and small, every day. Almost nothing can hide from Planet's cameras, including this unannounced Chinese naval exercise last year that in the past might have remained a secret.
What does it mean that you have democratized information and made it available that used to be the province of governments and intelligence agencies? What are the implications of that?
Yes, it's a little bit of a change towards a transparent planet. And I think it's so important that the pictures don't lie. You know, the picture is what it is. And sometimes that can be inconvenient. But it is also, I think, and I hope, will help us to transition away from this post-truth world towards a more grounded in facts. And some of those facts aren't always comfortable, but they're things that we need to grapple with. And so I think it's important that we get to that stage.
It's all part of a commercial satellite revolution, beginning a new age of discoveries about planet Earth.
Hey, NBC News viewers, thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Subscribe by clicking on that button down here and click on any of the videos over here to watch the latest interviews, show highlights, and digital exclusives. Thanks for watching.